Good afternoon to you. Welcome to the program Nigeria Now on Echo Television International, where we look at some of the stories that have been happening. And today we will be looking at quite a number of them, where we have the issue of the fuel scarcity, when NNPC have said that in the next 30 days they have sufficient fuel that Nigerians can have. So they do not need to actually, you know, hold the fuel in their homes. And also, we've seen that the Supreme Court have set Monday to be the day where they will be listening to the appeal of Atiku. And then finally, we would like to look at what INEC have to say about the credibility of the 2023 polls. I am Sarah Elisha Dashim, and I'll be doing the program together with Rachel Tansey. Good afternoon. How are you doing?
I'm fine. How about you?
I'm great. All right, remember you can join us live on Facebook and on YouTube, and as well drop your comment and your views on any of the story we will be looking at this afternoon. And just like I said, we'll be starting with the issue of fuel scarcity, Rachel. We will recall for about a week or more, 2 weeks now, we've been having the issue of the queues are resurfacing back again. Why? Because there is a scarcity of the fuel. We will recall that when the fuel subsidy was being removed initially, NNPC said they were going to open the market for other marketers to actually have an equal ground for competition. But we've seen that ever since the price of the PMS have increased, and then it seems as if presently it is only the NNPCL that actually is the monopoly of supplying this petrol. And Ipman, that's talking about the Independent Marketers Association of Nigeria, have said that for over a month right now, they haven't seen the fuel. And a lot of them, those who own the fuel station, because about 70% of the filling station are being owned by Ipman. So you could tell that if Ipman is unable to have access to petroleum, that is to say that there is scarcity. There is no argument about that. But here we are seeing yesterday, that's talking about Thursday afternoon, the NNPCL came out to say that Nigerians should relax. They are reassuring them that they have surplus of petrol that will sustain the country for the next 30 days. What questions will be after the next 30 days? What then happened? Because these are questions that Nigerians would like to know, because we will recall that the issue of inflation have increased, because we can definitely see that because of the scarcity of fuel, increase in price have definitely affected goods, commodity, and as well transportation. So you would definitely tell that because of the scarcity of this fuel, we cannot do without petrol, unfortunately for us. We've seen that the price of even gas have increased to 1,200. So whether we like it or not, it is imperative that the NNPCL actually do something to make sure that beyond the 30 days, we will have still surplus of petroleum in the market.
You know, Sarah, it's normal for us to see NNPCL coming out to calm Nigeria. It's almost like they are in the position. It's almost like they are in the position of INEC telling Nigerians, "Well, we've got this election. It's going to be smooth. Yes, we will deliver," and all of that. And I believe this is the position in which NNPCL are in, telling Nigerians that, you know what, there is availability of fuel for the next 30 days, and this has been clear out there for us. We know that the NNPCL procure fuel not for too long. It's always within this 30 days period, and when this 30 days is lapping, there is another one coming. And if only there were some procurement ahead of time, we might not be feeling the impact of dollar increase on the fuel pump prices, but that haven't been it. Now the question is, who is Nigeria going to believe in? Is it Ipman or is it NNPCL? Because one is saying there is fuel, there's going to be for the next 30 days, there will be supply. And Ipman is saying there have been scarcity. So meaning either way, there might be availability for the next 30 days. That is what INEC is assuring us. But in the past days, perhaps there was scarcity. And also, there are so many other factors in play here concerning scarcity of the fuel. We see where depots are shutting down because they cannot keep up with the exchange rate, because the landing price is going high, and then a lot of depots are not able to make it available. And then also, we've seen situation whereby there is forex exchange scarcity. The dollar have been scarce. So that have also affected marketers from making the fuel available. So even if, yes, the petrol is available, and NNPCL is saying it is available, we will see some scarcity because we have fuel stations closing down because they can't keep up with the exchange rate, and also because there is dollar scarcity. These are all the factors in play. So yes, we might have situation where we have marketers and the NNPCL having their different point of view of coming in concerning the availability of petrol in the country. But I believe that NNPCL is doing everything in their power to make sure that there is petrol supply for the next 30 days. And then we will wait to see if that is true. Because if marketers should continue to lament, then it means there is a gap somewhere. And perhaps NNPCL is not being sincere to Nigerians at the issue. Because whether we like it or not, these marketers are still in play. They are in charge of the distribution. So if they say, now we're looking at the big players here, if they are saying it's not available, then of course it is not available, because where is the fuel? Because we've seen scarcity even in Lagos, even in Abuja, we're seeing queues resurfacing and all of that. So it means for some reason the fuel is not, petrol is not in the quantity that is expected. So yes, it's not total unavailability, but there will be scarcity for some time though.
Richard, the only way Nigerians will believe the NNPCL, just like you rightly said, is when they begin to see that the queues are reduced.
Yes.
Because even as of this morning, the queues are still there. So Nigerians will be holding on to this word that NNPCL have said. Let us be sure that petrol will be made available. And we hope that soon the price, comparing it to the Forex, will actually be available so that marketers can get back into being the big players. Now, this morning we all woke up to the fact that the Supreme Court rather have accepted to listen to the petition, or to actually the appeal of Atiku. We will recall that there have been a saga back and forth between the PDP, the APC, and also the Labour Party, because they are the three contenders right now. And then we've heard where Atiku went back and forth trying to make sure that he have evidence or facts to actually rule out the fact that the present president, that is Bola Tinubu, is not qualified based on the fact that he is accusing him of forging his certificate. We've seen a lot of copies of the certificate was being made available to the press, where we see that one of the certificates was having Bola Tinubu bearing the sex as being a female. And we know that sometimes these things can happen, and a lot of people came out to say if this is forged, then the only people that can actually verify that is the court. And we've seen that the court have said Monday to be where we hear the fireworks coming in, because even the Labour Party had a press conference where he said that the president owed Nigeria an explanation. He needs to come out and tell us everything about himself. So it's more like reintroducing himself again. And we've also seen that even there have even been another saga for the PDP as well, because we've also seen where they said he was bearing Sadiq and that is not his name, and another came even for the Labour Party himself, where his brother came out to debunk all of that. So we begin to see that when you're trying to hold a party at this other place, you get to be accused for another thing. And these are things that we're bound to see. It's politics. So when we have things with politics, everybody will try to oppose whatever the other person said. It's permitted as far as it's being civil and nobody get hurt eventually. So right now, fingers are crossed to what the court is going to say on Monday. A lot of people are looking up to the court and saying, hope you will not shatter our faith. But right now, as it is, there's little or nothing Nigerians can do rather than to fold their arms and hope and trust that the judges will actually be very fair in their ruling come Monday.
The difference between every other accusation for Labour Party, it died down like immediately. It resurfaced when they tried to say, okay, Peter Obi don't have certificate. It died down like there and there. The same thing concerning Atiku Abubakar saying his name was Sadiq. He made mention why it was like that, and he has papers, files, from documents from the court showing that this is the reason behind it. So it died down. This topic didn't even pass more than 2 days. However, we are seeing that of the president lingering for a very, very long period of time. And that is the new basis why we are having the opposition party now taking this appeal again to the Supreme Court, saying let them rule out every other technical reasons in the past, and this is what they need to this is what they need, a fresh evidence exactly that the Supreme Court need to look into, and we hope that the Supreme Court will duly look into it. And if it's in the sense that we want to see, because I believe that the question here is not what qualification the president have. It doesn't matter if it's a diploma, a HND, a degree or whatever, but the authentication of that certificate, regardless of the level. And I believe that this is where the forgery steps into, not his school, not his school qualification or what level he went. As long as you have gone to school, we just want to see the original certificate proving that, yes, you have attained the level that you are fit and qualified to be the president of Nigeria. And we will wait, because this is very sensitive, and we have a lot of Nigerians expecting and waiting to see how the Supreme Court will go about it, because we have this candidate from the opposition party being confident in the Supreme Court, saying this is their last and final bus stop. And whatever the Supreme Court decide, that they will go with the ruling or the verdict of the Supreme Court, and they will agree with it. So it's just for the Supreme Court now to do the needful, and of course to not disappoint Nigerians, because the appeal court let go of the case, overruled, with technical issues that shouldn't be taken lightly in the first place. And yet we have the appeal court saying they are not even issues enough. Already Nigerians are disappointed with the fact that INEC did not come through as they should. Then why would the appeal court dismiss this case, saying that that technical issue is not a problem? And it's a little bit disappointing on a lot of level. And now we will see the Supreme Court, and we expect them to do much better, and of course give out a ruling with proof, with facts, that Nigerians will be happy regardless of the outcome. And just as we keep saying, regardless of who comes out victorious, your preferred candidate must not win. And who be it, the Labour Party, the PDP or the APC, somebody will be on the side that they won't be happy. It doesn't mean that justice haven't prevailed. It has. It didn't just favor you at that period of time. So Nigerians should keep an open mind to what the Supreme Court is going to do.
God, I mean, this is not jollof rice, even though not everybody loves jollof rice, and you will be happy with whatever verdict the court will give. But we just hope that we keep seeing this always whenever we get opportunity to do it, the fact that do not get in the fight of any of these politicians, you know. Whatever it is, be a patriotic citizen of Nigeria, regardless of who eventually the court say will win or whoever, because this is a game. We always have winners and losers, losers eventually. But the fact that you lose doesn't mean that you cannot give your own quarter to the contribution and also to the growth of Nigeria eventually. So right now, our fingers are crossed, and we hope that the Supreme Court will do justice to this case. Now, still talking about petition, a lot of cases, we saw INEC saying that about over 1,000 cases was being submitted, and then we've seen that about 700 or so was being dismissed, and then about 200 or 300 or so was being withdrawn, and then INEC is coming out to say that this election was credible. I mean, this election was the best. In fact, as far as INEC is concerned, there is no need for us to question this election, because all that was needed, because according to INEC, most of the reasons why people went to court was based on some things rather than from their own part. So it is that they played their own part, but then it was just the contenders that actually did not play their own part. But to some extent, it looks as if this is not what Nigerians will believe, because a number of things didn't play out well for Nigerians. We had issues where the beavers were not working. We had issues where INEC officials were not on ground on time. We had issues where voters were being harassed, maltreated. We had issues where some people were even disenfranchised because they were unable to exercise their own vote. So these were a number of things that came out. And I think even when we go back to the presidential election, these were part of the things. No wonder right now they're saying they should dismiss the technicalities if appeal court is not holding that as something. And a number of things came up where we are even seeing UN is even saying that INEC should actually give them the accountability of Nigeria's election, because for every election, it is a test that truly that country is practicing democracy. Because that is the only way you get to exercise your own right. I mean, if you are not okay with a leader, you're free to take the leader down and have another leader. But then beyond what INEC is saying, we are having an election coming up less than 3 weeks from now, which will be in Kogi, Imo, and Bayelsa. And I think that will be the test for Nigerians to know that if INEC truly is credible, because this is a body over the years Nigerians have questioned. At a point, Nigerians have even asked if truly INEC is independent, as he said it is, because if they are independent, they are not supposed to be partisan about anything whatsoever. They are supposed to be neutral. So right now, the eyes of Nigerians right now is, okay, yes, okay, some of them have been dismissed, some of them have been withdrawn, but then we need to see that beyond what INEC is saying, that they actually had the 2023 polls to be very credible. We are hoping to see that the remaining three states will also have the same testimony to say about INEC eventually.
It's very ridiculous for INEC to say because cases, petitions were withdrawn or dismissed, it means the election was credible. The fact that we already have those cases in court already discredits the election, because it's not even supposed to exist in the first place. It's supposed to be 2023 polls, both presidential, Senate, representative, governorship election was done, and everybody goes home. The fact that people felt the court have to decide a lot of things, and we're talking about major positions like governorship, we're talking about Senate. Up till now, we are having Senate members being sacked. We are having governorship candidates being sacked from their offices and another party being reinstated. So yes, just because those tiny, tiny, tiny petitions were dismissed or withdrawn doesn't take back that the 2023 elections lack credibility, because there are a lot of factors that are in play when it comes to withdrawal or dismissing of a case. It could be, there are many factors, it could be funding. Some parties or some individuals might not have the funds to continue to the next level, so they are left with no other option, because this is a petition against the federal government of Nigeria. So Sele, it takes a lot of money. So even for funding, some people will have to withdraw it, not because they don't have their rights or not because it was credible, but because they cannot go on. We can talk about settlements between parties. There are closed door settlements that do happen. There are agreements and all of those things that happen. And then secondly, sometimes the evidence, the period of time in which the court might have given you to appear and give your evidence, some people did not meet to that, probably because they didn't have the resources or access to some of these evidence that they are required. So these are a few among the many other factors that the court will dismiss a case, or people will withdraw their case from the court. So it has nothing to do with INEC's credibility. Yes, some might be as a result that the court have seen that, okay, you have no case here. But until we have a full detail to why these cases were dismissed or withdrawn, then before we can really give it to INEC. But even the fact that there are already those cases already says that there was a question mark attached to INEC's election. And Sele, even if not for anything, the fact that you promised us that there was going to be electronic transmission and you failed as a commission, that was already an election that wasn't credible whatsoever. And therefore, INEC is supposed to be in the position telling Nigerians, perhaps giving us reasons and apologizing and promising us that the remaining elections, they will come through because our eyes are open. And 4 years from now, come another 2027, that the general election in Nigeria will be smoother and better, because perhaps we tried a technology that we were not familiar with, but as time goes on, we're going to be better, we're going to improve as a commission, and we won't have these issues. This is what we need INEC coming from, but not rather than trying to just beat around the bush and give themselves credit when obviously we are seeing all the loopholes.
One thing for me is I'm looking forward to a day in Nigeria where after an election election, we don't see people going to court, because in the history of all the election we've had in Nigeria, it was only 2015 that we did not see maybe the presidential candidate that's coming between Jonathan and Buhari going to court. I mean, this was the first time we are having the president even calling while the count was still going on to congratulate Buhari. And he did that on his own conscience. Now, that is one thing or the other. But we are waiting forward to when Nigerians will actually go and Nigerians will determine. Because from the look of things, it looks as if the court is the one actually determining who will rule Nigeria at various points, whether presidential level or governorship or whatever level it is that we always go to do elections. So we're looking forward to a time where we do not have to need the court to do all of this. I mean, we've seen how the court have complained a lot about how stressful it was for them, because they're still having cases always and always. And I remember you making kind of, which made me laugh, you said that is the consequences when you said let's go to court, this is what we need. But then if you said out of the 94% are being, about 74.5% was being dismissed, well, we give them kudos for that. But then we will wait to see what will happen during the Kogi. Already we are having INEC complaining about insecurity, shorthand. So we hope right now that they are complaining that they do not have enough staff will not be a reason why on that day, November 11, we will not have them being in their respective polls early on time. So our fingers are crossed, and we wish INEC all the best to carry out their responsibility. And they owe Nigerians this. We want to see their result being displayed electronically. We want to see the beavers actually working well. And we also want to make sure that they are there on ground on time, even before Nigerians will queue up to actually exercise their franchise. But I think that's how far we can go. Thank you so much, Rachel, for doing this with me. And to our viewers and supporters, thank you for keeping the day with us on Nigeria. Now, to have a blessed weekend. Bye for now.